Right, so I'm going to show you how you can turn this into
this on the iPhone XR. So everything in this video will be filmed on the iPhone XR with some extras, which I'm going to explain in the video how you can make a video look like this as professional as you can get on the iPhone XR. So I have a tech channel and I film tech videos with my Nikon D3200 DSLR, but I also have an iPhone XR, and I think it's very useful that you have a good iPhone or a good other phone with a good camera in your pocket to film videos with for YouTube, for example. So first things first, the setup. In the setup, I have two soft boxes which shine from left and right on the sides of my face, and a top light which shines from the top down, which makes sure my face is equally lit. I also have a window there, but that doesn't really make a big difference. And I'm sitting here on a clean background, as you can see. As for microphone goes, I have the Yeti X, which is the new microphone from Blue. It's connected to my MacBook Pro via USB, and I have some settings going on over there, which I will explain later. I already said that I have a pretty clean background. It's not the cleanest, of course, but I think you can clean everything off your table. Maybe this water bottle shouldn't be here as well. But like, for example, you have a PC and you have your notepad, which looks nice, and a blue background with some stuff on the left and the right, but make sure your bed is made and everything, so you don't have all boxes in the background, which will give you a much cleaner video from the start. Now, part two of this video, those are the settings. Well, I'm filming this video on my iPhone XR, as you already know, in 4K 24 frames a second, which is the film mode on the iPhone. You have 1080p as well, and you have 720p, but I use for this one 4K because it's 4K, of course, and who doesn't want to use 4K right now? So I would definitely suggest using 4K with 24 frames a second in this case when you're filming a video like a tech video, for example, or a vlog or something like that. Next thing, if you want to film slow motion, there are two things you can do. You have the dedicated slow motion function on your iPhone, but that only goes to 1080p, which you can have in 240 frames a second, which is awesome. That's like very, very, very slow motion. Very, very much slow, but that's weird, that's not even English. But I would not really suggest that, because only maybe for sports videos you could use it, but you would have to upscale it, you would have to zoom it in order to get it in 4K. I would suggest filming in 4K, the highest resolution you can go in 60 frames a second, which you can then in post put in slow motion up to 24 frames a second. I'm going to show you that as well, how you do that in the next part of this video. So I already said I'm using the Blue Yeti X, and I use the Blue Sherpa app on my MacBook Pro with Blue Voice enabled, with the preset crisp and modern, but changed it up a little bit because I thought that it was not as good as it could have been. And here are all the settings I'm using on the Blue Sherpa app to have the sound you're hearing right now coming from the Yeti X. Now, part number three, that's the edits. Also very important. Of course, you need all your footage to be great, so you don't have a lot of issues when editing, but you can do some things when editing. If you film in 24 frames a second, as I've said, and you want your slow motion footage to look good, you film it in 60 frames a second, and then you just interpret footage and change it up to 24 frames a second, and it will be smooth slow-mo, as you can see, which is great. Another tip I can give you when you're filming in 4K, you can downscale to 1080p. So for example, make your sequence in 1080p, and then you can easily zoom in when you're using 4K footage without losing any quality, because you have enough pixels to zoom in on something without you having to lose quality when you zoom in on 1080p, for example, and you've only filmed in 1080p. Of course, syncing audio is pretty easy. You just merge the clips in Premiere Pro and it will sync from the audio point coming from your iPhone to the audio point coming from your Yeti X or any other microphone you're using. And last one, which everyone is using probably, is a bit of a color correction. It's not really necessary, but I think the colors coming from the iPhone X are a bit flat, not really flat, but like makeup style, I guess. And I just put on a LUT and it changes it up a little bit of a filmic vibe with a bit more blacks and a bit more contrast and stuff. So that looks better already. Right, this was a quick tutorial on how you can film good videos, nice, cool, professional looking videos on your iPhone XR. Of course, you need some extras to make this work, but I'm going to also make a video on how you can do this only using an iPhone XR with maybe household products and stuff, so you don't need to buy any of these things. But hey, it's possible using the iPhone XR. Let me know if you learned something, if you want to see something else, if you learned something else from this video maybe, and if you're going to use this, I would like to know. Don't forget to subscribe and like, and I hope I'll see you in my next video.